increasing human population and impacts of its activities on natural resources, Earth's environment has been undergoing significant changes, especially during 20th century. One of the most significant changes about human activities is an increase in the concentration of carbon dioxide and other greenhouse gases in the atmosphere. The concentration of gases reflecting heat would increase significantly. The doubling of these gases would increase the Earth's temperature by several degrees. The ill effects to emerge after few centuries and so on. It is feared that when all reserved fossil fuels are burned in another 300 to 400 years, the air temperature will rise by few degrees, resulting in catastrophic effects. Such melting of snow on the poles and mountain tops, causing rise in sea level and unprecedented flooding on land areas. The increase in global warming is almost equal to the increase in concentration of greenhouse gases of the atmosphere. The gaseous mantle around the earth permits a considerable portion of solar radiation to enter straight up to the surface of the earth. The gaseous envelope allows sunlight radiation to reach the earth, but when light radiates in the form of long wave radiation, it is absorbed by greenhouse gases and cause warming up. This heat is transferred to layers above, and warmer layers rises and in turn passes on to higher and higher layers. The atmosphere radiates part of this energy back to the earth. This downward flux of radiation is called greenhouse flux. Keeps the earth warm. The phenomenon is called greenhouse effect. The rise in temperature of earth's atmosphere caused due to the greenhouse effect depends on the amount of carbon dioxide present in the atmosphere. The carbon dioxide layer functions as a gas pan of greenhouse, which allows the sunlight to filter through it but prevents heat from being radiated back into the outer surface. As long as greenhouse gases keep the earth warm and cozy, the earth's gaseous mantle is changing the earth's climate alarmingly, not suitable to human beings. Global temperature had risen by only 4 degrees over the last 18,000 years, but because of rapid industrialization, it is increased by about 0.5 to 1 degree since last century. The rate of global warming during the past quarter century was greater than any previous period since 1880. The 6 out of 7 warmest years of last 130 years have occurred in the past 7 years. The scientists are concerned about the warming trend, and if this trend continues, the global warming is approximately 1.5 degree centigrade by 2015 to 2050 and 3 degree centigrade by 2050 to 2100 has been predicted. Global warming refers to the gradual rise in the atmosphere and ground surface air temperature and consequent changes in radiation balance caused mainly by anthropogenic progress leading to climate change at different levels. The concept of global warming may be discussed as follows. Percentage of contribution of greenhouse gases to the global warming, sources of greenhouse gases, effects of global warming, remedial measures of global warming. The causes of global warming are the gases that are responsible for increasing global temperature. Such gases are carbon dioxide, chlorofluorocarbons, methane, and nitrous oxide. The approximate contribution of the percentage of greenhouse gases to global warming is 61% by carbon dioxide, 15% by methane, 11% by CFCs, chlorofluorocarbons, 4% by nitrous oxide, and 9% by others. Ozone in troposphere also acts as a greenhouse gas. The Citizens' Fifth Report of Center for Science and Environment, 1999, New Delhi, revealed that emission of carbon dioxide has been held as the most dangerous and most significant greenhouse gas emissions, causing global warming. In the year 1995, about 22,700.2 million tons of carbon dioxide was estimated in the world. The share of world carbon dioxide emission is given in the table. USA 23%, China 13%, Russian Federation 7%, Japan 5%, Germany 4%, India 4%, Brazil 1%, Indonesia 1%. Five worst carbon dioxide emitter countries are United States of America, China, Russian Federation, Japan and Germany. In the report of the Intergovernmental Panel on Climate Change, IPCC, 1996, the trend of concentration of other greenhouse gases in the atmosphere was published. It has revealed that following facts. The methane release registered a phenomenal increase from the pre-industrial level of 700 parts per million by volume to 1724 parts per million in 1992. Atmospheric nitrous oxide increased from the pre-industrial level of 275 parts per million by volume to 311 parts per million by volume in 1992. The concentration of tropospheric ozone has doubled from pre-industrial level to 1993. Chlorofluorocarbons are dangerous and not only involved in the direct global warming but also in destroying ozone layer in the atmosphere. Carbon dioxide. The increasing combustion of fossil fuels, for example coal, petroleum, mineral, oil, natural gases, in the various industrial and also transport system has resulted increase of carbon dioxide gas in the atmosphere. The increase has been nearly 25% since 1850. In India, the contributions from coal, petroleum and natural gas and transport emissions are about 15 million tons of carbon during 1988 to 1989, which nearly causes 2.8% global warming. The trends in global carbon dioxide emissions 2012 report revealed that after a 1% decline in 2009 and unprecedented 5% surge in 2010, global carbon dioxide emissions increased by 3% in 2011 compared to the previous years. So, this trend is not followed to the same extent everywhere. The United States emission increased by 2% to 5.42%, while the biggest emitter China increased carbon dioxide emission by 9% to 9.7%. So, here this graph shows the variation of carbon dioxide emissions per capita in 2011 compared to 1990. The six biggest emitters per capita are Australia, United States, Saudi Arabia and South Korea, China, Iran and Taiwan. Ukraine and Russia are the leaders in the decrease for this period in percentage 52% to and 22% respectively. The European Union 27 has also a good result with 18% decrease for the total union, followed by the United States with 12%. Methane. Methane naturally emits from garbage dumps, but it is also a primary concept of natural gas. Rice fields, swamps contribute about 25 to 30% global methane production. India's contribution is nearly 6%. In Indian paddy fields, methane emissions is about 2% of the global paddy field emission and about 9% of global cattle contributions. Methane concentration in the air has been considerably increased from 750 parts per billion in 1750, 1750 ppb in 2000, global warming potentiality of the methane 11 times higher than that of carbon dioxide. The table shows the natural emissions of methane from oceans, estuaries and rivers. So, open ocean is 20%, continental shelves is 60%, estuaries and rivers is 20%. chlorofluorocarbons. Modern world is using chlorofluorocarbons quite frequently. So, these are used in foams, aerosols, solvents, air conditioners, refrigerators and others. So, India produces chlorofluorocarbons around 5000 tons per year against the global production of 7 lakh tons per year. So, world over, efforts are being made to reduce the CFC's production, but more than 15 million tons have already been released in the atmosphere by 1985. Following recent UNEP reports, 80% of emissions of HFCs, CFCs and also SCFCs originate from industrial countries. So, these include the USA, Europe with Russia, Japan and Australia. Only 20% of total F gas originate in developing countries. So, there are 4 kinds of fluorocarbons generated during diakens production process. HFC and PFC, which are covered by the Kyoto Protocol. Nitrous oxide. It is a quite stable gas with dual damaging effects. It is only greenhouse gas but also a ozone destroyer. The common sources of nitrous oxide production are natural soil, inland waters, oceans, fertilizers and burning of forests, grassland and other biomass. The global warming potentiality of nitrous oxide is 270 times higher than that of carbon dioxide. The concentration of nitrous oxide in the atmosphere has increased from about 270 ppb in pre-industrial time to about 316 ppb parts per million in the year 2000. The current emissions estimates, based on the available data, emissions of nitrous oxide from soils under natural vegetation are estimated at 6.6 tetragrams nitrogen per year. Many microbiological, chemical and physical parameters affect nitrous oxide emission, and complex interactions among these factors make accelerating global emissions budget difficult and uncertain. However, while the recent studies have been made in collecting and analyzing emissions measurements and the source strength of tropical soil has been characterized, there still exists lack of field measurements and significant model uncertainties. Natural emissions of nitrous oxide from oceans, estuaries and rivers. So, open ocean is 59%, continental shelves is 28%, upwelling zones is 7%, estuaries 4%, rivers 2%. Scientists are predicting various effects of global warming, particularly on climate changes and human diseases such as changes in cultivation and agriculture systems, biodiversity in the management practices. Taking into consideration of different predictions, the following generalization may be made. Global warming and climate changes. Global warming will have the larger effects on climate, which may be summarized as follows. It is predicted that by 2030, carbon dioxide concentration will reach about 600 ppm and average global temperature will rise by 1.5 to 4.5 degrees centigrade. Temperature rise will be more evident in the high latitudes in the northern hemisphere and in India. The temperature will go up by 1 degree centigrade in summer and 3.4 degree centigrade in winter. Global warming will affect rainfall pattern. In India, we will witness an increase in rainfall by 5% in summer and up to 15% in winter. In general, the rainfall will be enhanced over the northern regions and southern peninsula, with an expected decrease in central part of India, which is basically an agricultural zone. the level of sea water would rise by 20 to 140 centimeter in various parts of the world due to the global warming. In the last century, sea level has already risen by about 20 centimeter. The implied rate of rise is about 4 to 6 centimeter per annum, which is 2 to 6 times faster than over the last 100 years. There will be a marked increase in potential evapotranspiration, particularly in water stressed zone of the country. Ice and snow caps on mountains will melt, exposing dark surfaces, which will cause a further rise in temperature and reduce snowfall periods. Irregular rains and melting of snow on mountain caps will increase the flood incidents world over. Global warming and human diseases. World Health Organization has expressed concern over global warming, which would cause spread of malaria, which is already threatened about 2,100 million peoples of the world. Rise in temperature and rainfall affects the destruction of mosquitoes, which carry diseases like malaria, encephalitis, chikungunya, etc. Malaria is not found in the highlands of the Ethiopia, Kenya, Indonesia, part of China and South Africa, etc. And as such, these areas are threatened for such diseases due to global warming. Global warming will certainly bring about a change in distribution of communicable diseases, and vector-borne diseases could invade new areas and threaten the health of millions of people. Effect of agroecosystems. Dalwal et al. Predicted the following effects on agroecosystems due to global warming: increase in evaporation, rise in temperature of soil and water, reduction of snow period, increase in agricultural area, higher incidence of pests and diseases, increase in growth of wild plants, quick deterioration of soil fertility, enhancement of microbial activities, increase in decomposition rate of organic matter and fertilizers, increase in irregular rainfall, flood and water problems, increase in probabilities of occurrence of cyclones and hurricanes results in adverse effect on agriculture. Remedial measures to reduce the global warming means to reduce the production of greenhouse gases by limiting the combustion of fossil fuels, deforestation and CFCs using systems. Global efforts have been made on these lines, and following are some of the important measures. The Toronto World Conference, held at Toronto, Canada in June 1988, called for 20% voluntary reduction in the emission of carbon dioxide by the year 2005, especially by highly industrial countries like USA, UK, Germany, France and Canada, etc. By this reduction, greenhouse effects may be minimized or at least stabilized. However, some of these countries did not agree to the Toronto resolution, stating that such measures will adversely affect the progress of their countries. Representatives from 105 countries signed the treaty and resolved to stop warming of the earth and warned that only 8 years remain to save the world from its disastrous effects. G8 countries met at Germany, promised to reduce the production of greenhouse gases only half of from present level by 2050. Although USA diplomatically stated that cooperation from India and China is essential in this regard. To avoid problems which arose against the Toronto resolution, scientists must discover and develop alternative sources of energy and power and improve the better technologies. Technologies should be advanced and made more efficient to derive maximum energy from fossil fuels to reduce carbon dioxide and nitrous oxide emissions. Solar energy may be developed as alternative to the conventional fossil fuel energy, at least in those tropical countries where sunlight is abundantly available during most period of the year. Biogas may be considered as another alternative source of energy for domestic sector. Large scale afforestation and reforestation should be taken up, as forests are big natural sink of carbon dioxide. So, it is estimated that the forests cover of 120 million hectares can fix about 780 million tons of atmosphere carbon dioxide each year. So, it would reduce the release of carbon dioxide by combustion of fossil fuels and burning of firewood by 47% of the total annual release. Based on the information furnished on the topic global warming, it can be inferred that it is a burning global issue. We need to take some measures to control the emissions of greenhouse gases.